If you guys watched the last video that I did on World at War, you guys know that when I put it in my community tab, I asked you guys if you all wanted me to talk about the new Call of Duty that's coming out in 2021. And apparently the rumor right now is that it's called Call of Duty World War II Vanguard. It's the 27th of March, and it's been about a month or so since the first kind of leaks or rumors of Call of Duty 2021 have come out. I was reading Charlie Intel's article, and I'll read it right here. You know, if you guys want to read these articles as well, those will be down in the description below. You guys can go check out Charlie and all that stuff. So, also, if you guys don't know, code Foxy is 30% off at gfuel.com right now. 30% off from now until the 29th of March. So, you guys have until then to use my code for 30% off at gfuel.com and restock on all your G Fuel needs and all that good stuff. So, Charlie said that Modern Warzone stated in a video that the game was set to be in an alternate timeline where World War II never ended. And then Eurogamer disputed that and said that the game is going to be a traditional World War II setting, traditional being in quotations and stuff like that. So I have some opinions on this because obviously, if you guys have been here with me since 2017 when World War II first came out, you guys know that World War II is not my favorite game. I think it got better after the overhaul, but overall, I'm not the biggest fan of the game. I kind of wanted to talk about this and see what you guys felt and see what you guys thought about the next Call of Duty game being World War II, Sledgehammer being the developer for the game, because I think a lot of people will say that Sledgehammer is their least favorite developer, and I feel like Treyarch and Infinity Ward are a toss-up now. Because a lot of people don't like Black Ops Cold War, but a lot of people enjoyed Modern Warfare. So, and literally as I'm sitting here right now recording this video, I get a notification to my phone and Charlie Intel put an article out and tweeted that Call of Duty 2021 will run on Modern Warfare's engine. And this is a report. This is not official. And we're going to read some of this article real quick. Okay, so apparently a new report from the website VGC provides some fresh info on the 2021 Call of Duty game, which is rumored to be called Vanguard. Pretty much, according to a new article from VGC, the 2021 Call of Duty title is set to run on the new Modern Warfare engine introduced in 2019. And a lot of people know that Black Ops Cold War is not set on that engine. It's pretty visually obvious, and I would say gameplay-wise, it's pretty obvious as well. The visuals and movement in Black Ops Cold War are nothing like Modern Warfare 2019. That was one of the questions I was going to ask in today's video. I was going to ask you guys, you know, would you want the Cold War engine, or would you guys want the IW8 engine, which is the Modern Warfare 2019 engine, for the new game? If I'm going to be honest, I would like all the games to run on the Modern Warfare engine, but the mechanics of the game can't be like Modern Warfare. For example, mounting and just safe spaces. And yeah, I know the safe spaces have been in the older Call of Duty games like Modern Warfare 2 and all that stuff, but they were emphasized in this new game for Modern Warfare 2019. They were never emphasized in the older games. So that's one of the things that I hope stays away, that and mounting for sure. And then obviously from Cold War, requisitions and, you know, or the streak system that pretty much gives everyone free streaks, which I'm not that big of a fan of, all that stuff. Other than that, I pretty much enjoy Cold War for the most part. I just want there to be more variety within the game than there was in World War II. For example, in World War II, there was only 27 weapons at launch, and that was terrible. And then even with Black Ops 4, there was like 26 weapons at launch. And then Modern Warfare came out, and we had like 35, 40. Take what Modern Warfare did, but like fix everything. Like, you know, like have plenty of weapons there at launch, good maps. Don't put out maps like there was in World War II. I'm begging. Please. Just don't put out bad maps. And don't put out the same maps, because I'll make another video. It's just like, I don't want World War II Vanguard or whatever 2021 is going to be the same as World War II. I don't want there to be another World War II mess up. You know, obviously the game's gonna have bugs and things like that, like all games launch with bugs. If you guys played Modern Warfare 2 back in the day, you guys remember like the javelin glitch and all this other crap. And if you guys played Halo 3 back in the day, or if you played an MCC, like, you know, like it can't get that bad. And the only time I really remember a game not working at launch was World War II. That would be the equivalent of MCC, but even Master Chief Collection had way more issues than just not working, you know? I want the game to be successful, and I want the game to be really good, obviously. But those are the big things. I think that the streaks should be either kill streaks or regular score streaks, and that should be it. Give me those two options. Don't do this free streak crap. Don't do requisitions. The maps need to be good. The gunplay needs to be on par with Modern Warfare 2019. If you're gonna have it on that engine, then it should be running on that. It should be up to that standard. But don't do the mounting and safe space is crap. Sound design, personally, it needs to be better than World War II. I feel like World War II was super bland, and that's why I made the video of World of War sounds replacing World War II sounds. Modern Warfare 2019 sets such a high bar for realistic gun sounds and just sound design in general. It doesn't have to be too realistic, because too realistic is not good for video games, but it should be something that I can say, oh yeah, I can see that being the sound of that gun. Or I can, you know, I feel like, oh yeah, that's a badass sound. Personally, I have mixed feelings going back to a World War II setting. I don't mind it as long as they do it right. I feel like World War II, number one, it launched in a really bad state, which really sucked because it was super hyped. Everyone was like, oh my God, boots on the ground, and like all this other stuff. And then it kind of launched really, really poorly. To be honest, I think the gunsmith should come back, but I think it should be more geared towards Modern Warfare 2019's gunsmith versus Black Ops Cold War's gunsmith. I feel like Modern Warfare 2019 really held the bar super high. And then when Treyarch had to take over for Sledgehammer, apparently, and they had to go into crunch time and put out a game within 10 months during a pandemic, it really kind of shorted out on the gunsmith and other features that were available in Modern Warfare 2019. We all know the skill-based matchmaking is probably going to be a thing, so I don't really have anything to say about that. I think that if you're not brain dead, then you kind of know that skill-based matchmaking, like, that sounds really bad, but that sounds kind of harsh. But if you have some type of common sense and you have seen how the skill-based matchmaking has kind of changed the way that people are playing Call of Duty right now, you'll know that it's probably going to come back in the next game. And that sucks, but at the same time, it is what it is. It's not going away, and it makes them too much money. Like, it does. And that and Warzone. So that's the other thing, is that will Call of Duty 2021 be incorporated into Warzone? No one really knows at the moment. It's kind of up in the air. If they do, then how? I feel like a lot of people thought that Warzone was going to completely change when Cold War came out. And it did as far as the weapons being integrated, but the map hasn't changed too much. I mean, it's changed a bit, but it wasn't like, oh, we're going to nuke the entire map type change, you know? And I feel like a lot of people are still wondering if that's going to happen. And in this article that Charlie Intel just put out about the Modern Warfare 2019 engine being the engine for Call of Duty 2021, per VGC's article, the depth of integration between Call of Duty Warzone and Call of Duty 2021 remains uncertain. As of now, the two games are expected to share weapons and overall progression similar to the integration between Cold War and Warzone, and a new World War II themed map for Warzone remains uncertain due to quote-unquote scheduling issues and the significant change in time setting, VGC says. Personally, I don't think that Warzone will get a map change. It hasn't really happened for Cold War, and we're in March, almost May now. Warzone's been out for a year. A full overhaul of a map, I just don't see it happening. Especially, it would be like going backwards. I feel like a lot of people really dig the modern setting, and they don't mind that there's more weapon variety with guns like the MAC-10 or the DMR or, you know, the Krig or the M16 and things like that versus just the Modern Warfare weapons. I think that the weapon integration was really good despite how broken the Cold War weapons were and possibly still are in Warzone right now. I don't play a lot of Warzone, so you guys tell me in the comments what's broken right now. I'm pretty sure I got a good idea of what's broken at the moment. However, I still think that Warzone is going to play a factor. Obviously, Warzone makes them a lot of money. That's the big thing. If Warzone didn't make them a lot of money, we wouldn't be talking about, oh, is World War II Vanguard going to be incorporated into Warzone? I think what they'll end up doing is they'll end up integrating the weapons from the new game in 2021 and putting them into Warzone, just like they did with Cold War, and then we'll see what happens after that. And that's going to be that. So I just want to know what you guys think about this. Let me know down in the comments. If you guys don't mind leaving a like on this video, if you guys like this type of video, I don't mind doing them every once in a while. You guys know, if you guys have been here for a while, you guys know that I used to always voice my opinions and things like that. But I feel like this is a good topic to talk about, considering that, you know, World War II is a game that kind of pushed my channel. And I don't really like the game, but I will give it its share of props for, you know, the devs. All right, well, Michael Condry's out. Let's try and fix this game. And, you know, they tried. Like, I can appreciate that at Sledgehammer, and, like, they really did. So, yeah. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.